In this video, we'll look at how to add subtitles to a finished Dolby Vision master with the original metadata using DaVinci Resolve 18. First, set up a new project using custom YRGB color management, and set the Dolby Vision version and mastering display according to the info in the metadata. Now, import the finished Dolby Vision master and a subtitle sequence that matches the duration of this master file. Ensure that Resolve is using the correct input color space from the color management setting to flag the Dolby Vision master correctly. The file in this case was rendered as P3D65, ST2084, 1000 nits. Since the subtitle sequence was created in sRGB, select sRGB as the input color space. Also, change the alpha mode to premultiply. Now, create a new timeline from the Dolby Vision master and insert the subtitle sequence on video track 2. You will see that the subtitles are now displayed at about 90 nits, exactly how they were created in SDR. This is a good starting point, even in HDR. Depending on the light level of the background imagery, some titles may need to be adjusted to higher or lower luminance levels. The luminance level of the inserted text or graphic should be set relative to the background image. In order to adjust the subtitles individually, go back to the edit page and cut the subtitle sequence into individual shots. Now, check the subtitles on all the shots on the timeline and adjust them as required. You will see that brighter shots usually require brighter titles for better readability. Next, import the Dolby Vision metadata to the HDR video file on video track 1. Navigate to Timeline, Output Blanking, and click Reset because Resolve applies the global aspect ratio to all shots in the timeline, even to shots that have a different blanking value. To compare the subtitles mapped to SDR against the original Dolby Vision metadata, set the target display output and your reference display to SDR, and enable tone mapping preview. If required, adjust the brightness of the subtitles by changing their luminance in the HDR version. Ensure that the selected luminance value works for both HDR and SDR. Then, render a new PQ encoded video file that represents the subtitle Dolby Vision Master. This file, together with the original Dolby Vision metadata XML, now represents the new subtitle Dolby Vision Master.